Welcome again to today's presentation, which is on fowl typhoid that affects poultry. And this disease is becoming increasingly common in indigenous chicken, and also it is becoming common in other birds, such as the pigeons, which were formerly wild birds, but these days they are being farmed or they have been domesticated and they are being reared at the farm level. It is also common in the turkeys or turkey birds. The characteristic signs of this disease appears in chicks which are 2 months of age and above, and they are normally dull with rough wood figures and they appear sleepy. And the turkey chicks are not exempted from the disease. They also get the disease. And adult birds are also affected, and they appear drowsy. They have reduced egg production, and they appear sickly. And if you check the eyes are clear. They are not infected, but the birds are sick, and they are prostrate. They are not even able to stand. And the characteristic sign of fowl typhoid is a whitish diarrhea, normally referred as choke or choke diarrhea, which is very clear. At postmortem or at slaughter, the birds have enlarged liver, and this is 2 or 3 times bigger than the normal liver, and at times this liver has white spots, which are also characteristic of the disease. Another organ that is affected is the spleen, which is normally pea size, but with the fowl typhoid, it becomes the size of a very small egg. And if the birds are not treated, one might lose as much as 50% of the flock. And the pigeons, they are normally also affected with a high mortality. The contributing factors to this disease is the injectable mode of vaccination, which is very difficult for small-scale farmers. Another factor is the farming of the pigeons with the chicken, and the disease is transmitted from one farm to the other. Another factor is the improvement of the indigenous birds from the small dwarf birds that had few eggs and less meat to big birds that have more eggs and more meat, but which are not immune to the disease, and they are very susceptible. The disease can be treated as it is caused by Salmonella, which is a bacteria, and it has many drugs that can treat, but this treatment normally is not recommended, as the disease can be transmitted from the chicks, from the chicken to the chicks through the egg, leading to a perpetual presence of the disease in the farm. So as of now, the control of this disease that affects mostly the small-scale farmers who keep their chicken in the compound, at the backyard, or even beyond the compound, remains a vaccine which is injectable, with the hope that a vaccine that can be administered through drinking water and which is easy to administer will be available soon. So this brings me to the end of today's presentation. My name is Dr. Jacinta. If you are new to this channel, kindly subscribe so that you can get updated. So until next time, I thank you and welcome.